Hi folks, out of the north here again today. I'd like to talk today about long hair. Weird kind of topic, eh? Well, I'm definitely a child of the 60s, and something that really bothered me in the 60s was hippies. I don't like hippies. I don't like people who are too lazy to shave the shit off their face and cut the hair off their heads. I don't like it. That bothers you? Too bad. I don't like hippies. I don't like the idea of surrendering oneself to emotion. Don't like it. That's Eve's. You know, surrender yourself to Eve. You know, let's worship the Queen of Heaven. Emotion. Let's have a good time. Let's screw one another. I ain't into that. I don't like hippies. That was their ideology. Still is. A lot of hippies today, they just don't grow their hair long and let their beards hang out. Anyways, let's talk a little bit about long hair. We should go to a portion of scripture. I see now. I think it's in Zechariah 13 and 4. It says, on that day every prophet will be ashamed of his prophetic vision. He will not put on the prophet's garment of hair in order to deceive. Well, at another place it says that what the prophets wore were garments of goat hair. That's interesting. Goat hair. Goat hair is long. It's not kinky and curly like a sheep's hair. It's quite long, you know, and straight. And the prophets of old used to, you know, they put on these garments, goat hair garments, and thus try and, you know, use sorcery and divination to impress the people. You remember sorcery and divination, right? Divination is the observing of signs, times, and omens, you know. I see, therefore I deduce, you know. And of course, sorcery is the manipulation of situation and circumstance in order to evoke a response which might then be divined. Okay, so they put on these garments, acted like they were somebody. Just look at the magicians and stuff like this today. Well, more than that, look at the magicians, the politicians, look in the church, you know, or what they call the church, you know. You see these guys, they've got their long robes, they've got their, you know, their bishop's robe and all this kind of crap. And they're just trying to make an impression, you know, make people think they're somebody. The least among us is the greatest. But they don't believe that. They want to be on top. Okay. So the Lord says here, he's giving us clues, identifiers of what hair is all about. Let's go to another portion of scripture. Let's go to Jeremiah 7:29. Here it says, let's back up. Let's go to 28. Jeremiah 7:28. Start there. Therefore say to them, this is the nation that has not obeyed the Lord its God and has not responded to correction. Truth has perished. Truth has vanished from their lips. cut off your hair and throw it away. Take up a lament on the barren heights, for the Lord has rejected and abandoned this generation. When we go into Paul's writing, he goes into quite a bit of detail about this. In one place he speaks of long hair on a woman being to her glory, whereas long hair on a man is disgraceful, it's unnatural. Well, correct, here in Jeremiah he tells us to cut off our hair, get rid of it. Of course, the Old Testament law, men are warned, they're told to keep their hair trimmed. In another place it says, though, that they are not to cut the hair on the sides of their faces. Seems kind of weird, a guy running around with a decent haircut and ringlets hanging off his jowls looks like an absolute idiot. I can't see the Lord making fools of us like that. But if long hair is a figurative word representing deception, then the scriptures begin to make sense. Eve, emotion, is very deceiving. Where emotion is involved, evidence is not required, because the emotion becomes the evidence. You know what I mean? So when you're dealing with women, emotion, okay, long hair is okay. But when you're dealing with logic, long hair is not okay, because long hair deceives. It deceives. Just because everybody's mad about something doesn't mean that what they're mad about is right. It doesn't make sense. You have to use logic. Logic has to come into it. So, long hair, deception. If we're to have long hair on the sides of our face, how does it say? Fix your eyes upon Christ, nary looking to the left or to the right. Fix your eyes upon Christ. Christ is truth and love in flesh. If we fix our eyes on truth and love, then all the other stuff, it's long hair, isn't it? It's just deception. Don't look at it. Don't bother with it. Don't waste your time on it. Lots of people want to point at sin all the time. They always want to point at sin. Oh, you did this, you did that, you're this, you're that. Their eyes are not fixed on Christ Jesus. They're not fixed on truth and love. Their eyes are fixed upon all the deception at the sides. There's something I didn't mention that I really think should be mentioned in this video. Remember I talked about Paul, and he spoke at length about long hair. And in that discourse on long hair, he said it was a disgrace for a woman to speak in church. And there's a lot of people who hold to that teaching from a very literal perspective. A lot of people that hold to the literal perspective of picking up serpents and drinking deadly poison too. Does that make them right? No. When we gather as a group, church, a fellowship, Jesus said, where two or more are gathered in my name, not your name, in his name, he said, there I am. A lot of people forget that. They gather as a church, they call it fellowship, potluck supper, good times, songs, prayer. Too often a deceiver will stand before the group, claim he's somebody, you know. He's got the long beard, and he's got the funny hat, you know what I mean? He's got the robes, he's it. He's at the Red Sox. So is it a disgrace for a woman to speak in church? Let me say it this way. Is it a disgrace for woman to speak in church? The answer is yes. A woman? No. Woman? Yes. When we gather to search the scriptures, to study, to show ourselves approved, capable workmen, knowing what's contained in here, knowing what God's word, having heard God's voice, and knowing what his word says. When we gather as a church, we should be gathering in our Lord's name. He's the word. We should be seeking the logic side, Adam's side, not Eve's side, emotion. Emotion does not belong when you're discussing scripture.
Oh, you hurt my feelings.
Yeah, too friggin' bad I hurt your feelings. I didn't hurt anybody's feelings. You're sitting there reading the Bible. You read something in the Bible. You bring it to people's attention, and all of a sudden it hurts their feelings. That's disgusting. That's utterly disgusting. And when I say, when Paul says it's disgusting for woman to speak in church, we mean it. It is disgusting. Leave your emotion at the door. It doesn't belong. We're here to reason, and we're here to find the evidence that points directly at the voice of God. We're not here to paddle each other's bum, kiss each other's ass. Forgive me. It's a touchy subject with me, because I've known a lot of girls, a lot of females of the human species, who have been treated like absolute shit by husbands who are as dumb as dirt. And you want to know something? They behave like women. It's always emotion. I'm the boss. Shut up, woman. God's not looking at gender. And his word is not talking about gender when it speaks of man and woman. It's talking about logic and emotion. And emotion has no place in the house of God when we're studying the scriptures, trying to put it together. Emotion has no place. Leave it at home. It's disgusting. So we should do what the Lord tells us to do. We should get rid of the deception. Speak the truth. Jesus is Lord. He is the one true God and eternal life. 1 John 5:20. And he wants us to love one another. Fix your eyes upon Christ. Long hair? Don't like hippies. Never have. Still don't. Bye for now.